أو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. You're Allah's chosen one.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Imam Kashif Ahmed recording from the Prophet's Path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us many bounties and great ni'mat. And one of the greatest ni'mat of Allah is our eyesight, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered each and every believer to utilize and use the ni'mat according to the orders of Allah and according to the guidelines that has been put forward by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal has ordered the believers in the Quran, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jal has told Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell the believers to lower their gaze and protect their private parts. This is more purifying for them, and this will give them a life which is purifying, and it will make Allah Azza wa Jal happy, and it will get them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Under the commentary of this ayah, Ibn al-Qayyim Jawzi rahimahumullah writes that all the desires that develop in the heart of an individual is due and is by the usage of his or her eyes. When a person uses his or her eyes according to the orders of Allah, by looking at things which are permissible, by looking at things which will increase the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then indeed the actions which will be committed by that individual will be pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we misuse our eyes, look at things which are haram, look at things which are not permissible, then indeed we do not appreciate the ni'mat of Allah, and the nur, the light of that eyes is distinguished, and a person does not take benefit from the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, النَّظْرَةُ سَهْمٌ مَسْمُومٌ مِّنْ سِهَامِ إِبْلِيسِ, that the sight of an individual is one of the deadly arrows of shaitan through which shaitan attacks. When you look at something, the desire develops in our heart, and this desire takes us to those actions and make us commit those sins. Later on, we regret in our life that we wish we never did that action. This is why taking the advice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and taking the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we should try our best to protect our sight by only looking at things which are permissible. If an individual accidentally looks at a thing which is haram, maybe looking at a woman which you are not supposed to look at, then immediately we should turn our sight, our gaze, or lower our gaze. And on this, Imam Ahmad narrates the hadith in his Musnad, in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a person who looks at the beauty of a woman which he is not allowed to look, then he realizes that he's looking at something haram, and he changes his sight, he starts looking down, or moves his sight away from that wrong, Allah Azza wa Jal will give him the beauty of Iman, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will strengthen his belief through which he can adopt the path of goodness and protect himself from the wrong action and from haram. So we take this advice of Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we implement it into our life, bringing the orders of Allah into our life by protecting our gaze, looking at things which are permissible, and not to look at things which are haram. And also we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability and the strength to live our life according to His orders, and make us among those by our action we are pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله خيرا وأحسن الجزاء. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.